Hello, and welcome to our channel. My name is Dmitry, and I'm a part of the ExactPro research team. At ExactPro, we build software to test software. Check out our website if you want to learn more about us. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell button to stay up to date with our videos. We are continuing our series for people preparing for the STQB exam. Today, we're going to talk about the second part of Chapter 5 called Test Management. If you missed the previous videos, you can find the links in the description below. Let's pick up where we left off. The next thing we need to do in the test management process is establishing test monitoring and control. The purpose of test monitoring is to gather information and provide feedback and visibility about test activities. Information to be tracked may be collected manually or automatically and should be used to assess the test progress and to measure whether the test exit criteria are satisfied. Test control describes any guiding or corrective actions taken as a result of metrics gathered and reported. These actions may cover and affect any software lifecycle activity. Let's look at some of these metrics. 1. Percentage of planned work done in test case and environment preparation. 2. Test case execution, for example, number of test cases run and passed. 3. Defect information, for example, defect density, defects found and fixed, failure rate, and confirmation test results. 4. Test coverage of requirements, user stories, acceptance criteria, risks, or code. 5. Task completion, resource allocation, and usage. And 6. Cost of testing. Here we compare it to the benefit of finding the next defect or to the benefit of running the next test. One of the most essential activities of the test team is to mitigate risks. Risk is a possibility of a future event which has negative consequences. At this stage, we classify them into product and project risks. A product risk involves the possibility that a work product, a specification, component, system, or test may fail to satisfy the legitimate needs of its stakeholders. When the product risks are associated with the specific quality characteristics, functional stability, reliability, performance efficiency, usability, security, compatibility, maintainability, and portability, they can be also called quality risks. Let's say we're releasing a new matching engine. The deadline is near, but there are still some bottlenecks where the response time is subpar. The project team makes a decision to deploy it despite the shortcomings. They stick to the timeline, but the end users might observe latency deterioration. This is a product risk. A project risk is a situation that may have a negative effect on the project's ability to achieve its objectives. We can review the matching engine example again. Now the project team decides to address the response time issues. As a result, the end product will satisfy the stakeholders' expectations, but they may miss the deadline or exceed the budget. That will be a project risk. A risk-based approach to testing provides proactive opportunities to reduce the levels of a product risk. It involves the analysis, which includes the identification of various hazards and the assessment of their likelihood and impact. The resulting information is used to guide the test planning, specifications, preparation, and execution of test cases, as well as test monitoring and control. Analyzing product risks early contributes to the success of a project. What other test management responsibilities does the team have? They include configuration management, defect management, progress, and status reporting. The team needs to establish and maintain the configuration integrity of the system, the testware, and their relationships to one another through the project and the product life cycles. All test items, testware, and documents should be uniquely identified, version controlled, tracked for changes, and related to each other. Finding defects is not enough. All of them should also be logged. The way it is done may vary depending on the context of the system under test, the test level, and the software development lifecycle model. But any defect identified should be investigated and should be tracked from its discovery to resolution. This may include correction of defects and successful confirmation testing of the solution, as well as deferral to a subsequent release or acceptance as a permanent product limitation. In order to successfully deal with bugs, an organization should establish a defect management process, which includes a workflow and rules for classification. This process must be agreed on by all those participating in defect management. In some organizations, defect logging and tracking may be very informal, although a casual attitude toward defect tracking might have adverse effects on the process. If bugs are raised only verbally, then what are the chances that some of them get overlooked? If a bug gets fixed but never logged, then there is a chance that the traceability is lost and we don't know the defect's origins. Who's to say that the same bug won't be introduced in all the consecutive builds? So, for the sake of informality, bugs get lost and causes get uninvestigated. There has to be a centralized bug tracking system to avoid all of that, as well as to help evaluate the QA department efforts. During test monitoring and control, the test manager regularly issues the test progress reports for stakeholders. In addition to common progress reports, they may also include information about impeding factors, testing planned for the next report period, and the current quality of the test object. When the exit criteria are reached, the manager issues the test summary report. This report provides a synopsis of the testing performed based on the latest progress report and any other relevant information. It is not enough that the testers know the outcome of the test. All of the stakeholders need to know the scope and the result of testing in order to make informed decisions about the software. This concludes our today's video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. In the next one, we will talk about Chapter 6, titled Tool Support for Testing. Meanwhile, we have tons of interesting content for you on our channel, so feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button to be the first to see the new videos. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.